Everything you need about 2D plotting in MATLAB is in this video. The basic command to plot in MATLAB is plot x, y, in which x and y are vectors. I define x equals to 1, 5, 6, 9, 11, and y equal to 17, 15, 19, 23, and 20. I plot x, y. Remember that x and y must be of the same size. Now let's add a little spice to it. The default setting is a solid blue line, but we have control over it. Here is a list of possible colors, markers, and line types you can choose from. For example, KX colon means a black dotted line with X-shaped markers, or RS dash means red solid line with square markers. I hope you can see the markers clearly. Now I plot a line using two points, plot 10 and 15 for X component and 7 and 9 for Y component. Let me add a square marker to it. You see, it's not clearly visible, so I need more settings. These four line properties can help me: line width, marker size, marker edge color, and marker face color. I set the marker size to 20, marker face color to black, marker edge color to red, and line width to 5. You see, it is much better now. If I run two separate plot commands, the second one will overwrite the first one. But what if I want to have two plots at the same time? There are two ways to do it. One way is to run all of your plots in the same line. Plot x and sine of x, comma x and cosine of x. Or after plotting the first one, I run hold on command. This command will freeze the plots and prevents overwriting them. You see, the second plot is added to the first one. I type grid on, box off, axis off. These on or off settings can help you create a meaningful graph. Also, you can run the figure command and every time it opens a new window, ready to plot a graph in it. I plot x, sine of x, x, cosine of x, and I set the line width to 4. Now we can add labels and text to our plot. X label, displacement x. Y label, sine of x, whatever label that you like. Title, sine of x versus x. To add the text, you have two options. One is text 0, minus 0.1. This is the exact coordinate where the text will appear, comma, origin. Or use gtext origin and put the text wherever you like with your mouse. Now I add a legend. Legend sine of x, cosine of x. You see, the blue line is sine and the red one is cosine. We can change its position by adding location NW. You see its position changed. This picture shows every location option. Let me try east outside, or alternatively EO. Another important aspect of a graph is its axis limits. To set the axis limits, I use this command. Axis minimum of x, maximum of x. Minimum of y, maximum of y. I could do all these settings using the plot editor. I can reposition the legend manually, add a text box, change labels and title, insert shape, pan, zoom, etc. And last but not least, how to add multiple plots within one window. Subplot command divides the window into multiple plots. I type subplot, I divide the figure into 3 rows and 2 columns, comma, index 1, plot x, comma, sine of x. Then I subplot, again I say with 3 rows and 2 columns, comma, 2. I plot x and cosine of x. This picture shows how subplot reads each graph. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.